Alrighty, so week eight attendance. Whew. I know it's going by quick, right? A couple of things I want to say on this attendance. One is that I'd like your feedback on something on the Learn Together week seven that you guys and gals completed for last night. One thing I did is I spent a little more time actually going through the code. And I would be curious if you want to have me do that detail on the last Learn Together for next week. Like, did you listen? Was it beneficial? Because if it wasn't, cool, I won't. If it was, I'd be more than happy to, but I would just like to hear. The thing about that, though, is that for those of you, and some of you don't look at this until the day it's due, so, which I noticed, it's kind of human nature sometimes. Part of the reason we set due dates as instructors is to get you to work on things. And I've been in trying to encourage you to actually work ahead of the due date whenever possible. And we're at the point of this class where, the more, and remember the strategy we have here, right? The reason I do the Learn Togethers is to get you to work on development, the develop it too. So that the more work you do on development two, the more likely you're going to succeed. Okay, so there is a plan, believe it or not. But I also get this reality, and this is actually not unique. I used to think it was unique to me, but I found out after talking to a lot of different developers, coders, programmers, engineers, that it's actually a thing around coding too. Is that I noticed, and I noticed it because of last weekend with DevFest, I had 3 days away from coding. And I noticed that for me, and I think it's probably because I don't have a job allows me to work code every day, that it is really sometimes a challenge that if I've taken a break to get my head back into that code. And that is pretty normal. And so what happens is, and I'm not saying there could be one or two, I'm not sure, because I don't see when you work, but what I see is that most of you are submitting right at the due date for the Learn Togethers. And so if the only time you're picking up to do code for this class is on the code ups or in the Learn Togethers and you're struggling, it's probably not enough time. I shouldn't say probably, because the truth is, it depends on the skill, what you brought in, how much time can you give the code ups, how much time do you have, right? So there's so many different factors that can go into this. I just know for me, this was true. Was that when I, because I needed to finish up, and thank God I did actually finish up my last parts of Develop It 2 requirements, and I'm gonna actually. Just, I'm not going to show you here. I have it ready, but I think what I'm going to do is hold that until I actually do the last Learn Together video, which is why I'm asking if that was beneficial at all. The reason I did it and I said it in the video was to give you an example of what it would look like when you are in a code review. Because the idea of a code review is you come in with working code, and I talked about that last week of the how I grade this work. As far as if it's working or not. And so, but last week or on the video, that's why I went through it in a somewhat of a detail. But I'm willing to do a longer one, break it into two if you found it helpful. I'm just not sure because I didn't see any of this, right? Was that helpful for you? To hear that kind of detail, and would you like me to do it longer or more or whatever, to give you the example of not only how to talk about it, but what that code's doing? Because that's the thing right now we're all doing in this class is we're taking what we've learned and we're creating something, which is, by the way, what everyone I talk to in this industry tells me is really where you learn, because you'll get a level of learning. A level of knowledge from what coding along. And you get another level of knowledge when you are actually doing it, taking your own concept and creating something, right? And I just know for me, that's true. I get a whole new level of muscle memory, understanding, clarity, to where I can take the ideas that I have and translate them into working code. So I get it, right? So we are at the 2 weeks, right? So we're 2 weeks left. I know this has gone quick, and I know a couple of you make comments about that. You know, you really wish this had been 18, and I've suggested to the campus that we do hybrid 18 week next semester. So, and I talked about my other courses, which I appreciate your feedback about that. So, this week, right? So coming into week eight, right? So it's the last opportunity. So we have a code up, right, for week eight, which is nine, which is really more of just adding new, learning new functionality, but not really implementing anything new, right? So at this point, even though some of you may are still working on getting the requirements down, we're really just learning to refactor some of the things that we've done, like functions, right? Learning how to do arrow functions this week. So just FYI, and as I said last week, and I'll say it again, I do not have any of the section 10, which I ended up paring that down to less number of videos to watch, but I do not have any of those in the requirements, right? So FYI, I just want to be clear about that, but you still have a couple of videos you'll need to code along for that section, right? So, you know, at this point, and I'll reiterate this again, because I think it's important. And I know that, you know, based on your schedule and mine, sometimes it's a challenge for us to connect, but here's what happens. So if you reach out to me and you want to meet with me, I'm like, great. The first thing I'll say back to you, here's my appointments, right? And I'll tell you, and if you don't know, I've been talking about them when they are, right? But it might be worth saying, right? So Monday and Wednesday, I'm on Fresno City College campus. My official hours are from 1 to 1:50. I can be there earlier, a little bit earlier. I can stay a little bit later. If you're needing an evening appointment, those will probably be online. And I suspect that works fine for you as well. But what I will do is say back, well, here's my office hours. Do those work? And then we figure out between us what is a time that can work. Because, you know, that's the idea, is that I want to be there. But we just have to negotiate that based on the requirements that are hitting us. Like for me right now, part of the reason it was so important for me to get done what I wanted to get done for this class was because I have two other classes I need to get ready. I have code reviews for you all, which, by the way, Jared already signed up. That's awesome. You can sign up for those code reviews, but you can see me. I recommend seeing me. The sooner the better, to at least give you some ideas around, you know, especially if your code's not functioning, you're trying to figure out how to make that work, which I'm going to circle back around to. I do think if you watch my week seven Learn Together and pay attention on that backside where I actually go through that code, it might help you, because you're implementing for your idea those same basic ideas, right? Create, read, update, and delete, right? So, but those are like, this is how we organize our thoughts, but it's really, how are we implementing those in the code that we've learned, right? How are we using the form inputs, either the inputs or the form itself? Remember, by the way, important to understand there's a difference, right, between just having an event listener on an input field and having it on a form. And it's not a big difference, but you do have to do the prevent, you know, e-prevent default, because a form has a way that it has been over the years implemented in the browser. And so, and it's going to do a particular thing that we have to, for our purposes and for most purposes, truly, is actually stop that default behavior. But that's not true when we're actually just looking at inputs, right? And we're doing event listeners. And which is better? It depends on your app, right? For my app, right, I have an event listener on my player field. I have an event listener on each of my images, right? So I end up with four event listeners, one for the input field, one for each of the images. Sorry, so that's four, and actually one more. So if somebody goes back into the input field, right? And there was a comment made, I think it was by Oscar. He was saying, we haven't done validation. And that's true, but we can also handle just as I did, right? This idea, right? So you can easily, like if somebody tries to go play because I'm listening for an event, I can say, hey, you know, you can't do that. So you can just present some data, some information back. And then that's my other event listeners when I start updating, right? So if there's any input, I think is that event listener for that, right? So there are ways with what we've learned to handle, right, validation so that you can make sure, and I said this, I think, to possibly somebody else, is when, because right now I want everyone to give us links in using either, some of you are putting it on github.io if you have one already set up, or I've showed how to use the Git hack so that we can all interface, we can all check out what you have, right? And the first thing I will do is actually open up the inspect, right? So one of the first things I do when I go is I look at the inspect. Oh, wow. Oh, I was like, what happened here, right? So this is good too, right? So is to actually go, I wonder how it happened here, right? So these are actually just warning messages, content script. I have to figure out where those come from because that's actually not from my, it must be something on my CSS. First time I've seen those, because I always, that's always the first thing I do when I'm actually looking at somebody's code is I will go in there. First, is there an error on the render page, right? These are just warnings, but I want to go find out what they are. But then I interact with the app and see if there's an error, right? And if there's no content generated, then I go and look at the code and try to figure that out. So, and that's pretty typical, right? That's like what's going to happen. And that's probably what you want us to do, right? You want us to figure out, you know, or you can point us to where you're having issue and then we can be more helpful. But again, working ahead will be helpful in that respect. Enough for today, I think. So the parting question that I started with that I'm going to say again is, right, is it would, was it beneficial? Did you listen to it? Do you want me to do it for the last Learn Together, right? So the last one, I could even do it and put it on the develop it too. But if you're not watching this until a week from today, I will probably already have made a decision, right? And the thing is, sometimes here's why I don't do that without a request is because if it's not graded optional, we all know this. If something's optional, it often doesn't get done. So if you haven't benefited from it, right, then was it not beneficial? So for some of you, it may not have been. That's okay. It's not going to hurt my feelings. But if anyone found it beneficial and would like to have that level of detail for my last develop it, totally, or my last Learn Together, totally willing to do that. All right. It is Friday, week coming into week 8, 2 weeks left. It's going to giddy up, my friends. I hope I see some of you next week. I really do, because that is the sooner, the better. Because if you're reaching out to me and just saying, hey, why can't I get this? It's probably not the best use of both of our times. I'll do my best to try to help troubleshoot, but it really works better if you and I are having a discussion. Because, you know, just telling somebody here's how to fix your code is not always the best thing. It's more to help, you know, get an understanding of where you're at and see where we need to help give some more information so that you can implement your idea, right, into your development project. Okay, I am really going to quit this time. Have a great weekend. Talk to you soon.